Last week, we invited Romney and Gingrich for a one-on-one conversation on Face the Nation. Romney wanted no part of that, but Gingrich agreed. And in an interview on his campaign bus, he told us why he now says Romney is too dishonest to be president. Here's the interview. Let me ask you this. I mean, are you worried about the law of unintended consequences? I think you've made Mitt Romney a pretty good debater. He was not bad in these debates.
Well, he's gotten better because he's gotten a coach, but the problem he has, I think you'll see in the next day or two, is that it's really useful in a debate to use facts to win. And I think it's really dangerous in a debate to use non-facts to win, because you win a tactical victory, but you strategically begin to destroy your own credibility.
There were a couple of times during the last debate in Florida where you seemed to just stop for a moment.
I did.
Why was that?
Because what he was saying wasn't true.
But I mean, you're never at a loss for words. Were you just shocked or what?
Yeah, I mean, look, when somebody says to you, I've always voted for the Republican when the opportunity existed, and Larry Sabato tweets within minutes that what Mitt said wasn't true. That in fact he could have voted for George H.W. Bush or Pat Buchanan on the day that he voted in the Democratic primary for Paul Sanger. Lincoln once said, if a man won't agree that 2 + 2 = 4, you'll never win the argument because facts don't matter. Romney's the first candidate I've seen who fits the Lincoln description.
You're running a pretty tough ad down here now. Basically, it starts off with Mike Huckabee saying if a man is dishonest in getting a job, he'll be dishonest on the job. Are you saying that Mitt Romney has a character flaw here, that he's just dishonest?
You and I have had this conversation
three times. Yes, we have.
There are a series of things that happened in the debate that are factually false. Now, this is a smart man, and as you point out, he was well coached. He came into the debate prepared to say things that are false. I'll let you decide whether that's clever or whether that's really bad. I think somebody running for president has a unique requirement to be honest, because the only way you lead the American people is by having them believe in you. And just take the one example I gave you. It is a fact in 1992, he gave money to Democrats for Congress. He voted in the Democratic primary for Paul Tsongas, who was the most liberal candidate. That's just he could have said, yeah, you know, I was in Massachusetts. What? I mean, he could have admitted it. He stood there, and this is why several times during the debate, if you go back and look at it, I'm standing there controlling myself, because I didn't want to get into a running fight at that moment when I knew what he was saying was so false that the better way to handle it is to get the data, lay it out, let people make a judgment on their own. I mean, the election wasn't going to be the next morning.
If you don't win Florida, what happens? Do you keep going?
Oh, sure. I mean, I think when you're ahead 52-39, why would you quit? But I think there's a very high likelihood we're going to win Florida, because I think when people understand how many different times last night he said things that weren't true, his credibility is going to just frankly collapse.
Mr. Speaker, I want to thank
you. Good to see you, Bob.
Okay.
Thank you.